All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back once again to our set here for this evening in the North American StarLadder Star Series Season 14. It's between FollowEsports and Coastless. FollowEsports currently leads the way after coming off of Mirage with a 1-0 set lead. One more here on Inferno, and they take it for the night. But if Coastless strike back, that's going to take us to our third and final map on Dust 2. Speaking of which, my name is Blue, and joining me this evening is Mega Man. So Mega Man, what do we expect to see here on our second map?
Well, it all really comes down to this knife round right here. This is gonna have some serious implications. Obviously, the Coastless side wants to start on CT. They're not gonna get the option as they just get completely destroyed in the knife round. So that's a huge start to this one for FollowEsports because there are no slouches on this map. I got to see a little bit. I was watching, I believe it was Flom stream the other day when they had a match against FollowEsports on this very map. And T side for FollowEsports looked really strong in Premier. I didn't stick around to see how their CT side looked, but I assume it was okay. But yeah, Coastless being on Terra side to start off, that's kind of a bummer.
Yeah, so indeed, we'll see how well they're able to sort of forge through things here. I as well sort of don't really have a whole lot of knowledge in regards to how strong this new FA roster is going to be on this map, as I mainly, of course, cast over the EPL, so haven't really been seeing them too much, of course, in their sort of conquest. I believe they're in Premier, of course, but we haven't really been seeing too much of them as of yet, so it's going to be a good test tonight, but Coast is, of course, having all sorts of issues with trying to get this new roster together. ScrunK has been a good pickup, but lemz, I believe they're still working out some issues with him, so that's still being a factor, and with the inconsistencies that we discussed before we actually got started with the set still being in play here, might not end up looking so good, especially with FE getting the good start back over here on the CT side.
Yeah, I actually just looked it up for the time being, and that match that I was telling you about, Noble Esports versus X Elevator Follow Esports, was 16-14 for Follow Esports on Inferno. So, Elevate won 9-6 on their terrorist side, and then it was 8-7 in the second half. So Noble Esports picked up 8 rounds on their terrorist side. So, you know, CT side for Follow Esports, even though it looks like that's what they chose, and they just demolished, they demolished the pistol round, that's, they're going to really need to string rounds together here to keep Coastless at bay. Now you see Char actually drops lemz, comes in, which is Coastless' actual fifth, so that could have a little bit to do with this as well.
So we'll see how well, and we talked about this before too, some of the issues with lemz about how he's sort of been struggling to find his role here on the team, and we've been seeing some matches where he just wasn't able to perform that well at all, so it's going to beg the question if we'll see it here on this map, and by the opening performance, of course, that could be something that gets into the way. Right from the get-go, of course, them getting shut down at the crossroads, not even able to make their way past that as FE just rush it, and they pick up the pistol round off of the hinges of this, so Coastless will look for a response here, round number two, but to some degree, FE are expecting this. You can see they've already gone for four players on upgrading to the rifles here, and Peter actually takes the light buy. He just goes for the 5-7 armor buy-up.
A little bit of harassment over that B-bomb site. The bomb is actually down in alternate mid right now, so a lot for Coastless to actually do still in this round. They don't really have any map control. They're just lurking around for the time being. Slemmy watching like a hawk over here by balcony. He's just going to be spotting for anybody to encroach on that position. Here's the footsteps in the top side of mid by Boiler, I believe. And that's where this push is going to be coming. It's going to be wrapping around on truck side, and this is going to be aKis to try to hold things off. FGB is over here harassing. They do have bracket control now for the terrorist side, but very turtled up on the defense here. And Peter with the 5-7, he's looking for anything that he can find. And all that he's going to find is 20 damage to himself. But he does manage to find one. Crushing over here. Now they're trying to go for a little bit of a wrap play, but they can't make it happen. ScrunK is caught out in the open. And he's probably going to get caught here as a knife kill. Ooh, baby.
Just leaps in, gets the knife.
Well, that happened.
Complete whiff from the pistol. So we got a pause from Coastless already. Ping issue. Oh my goodness, really big ping issue on invert. Yeah, that's a little bit more warranted.
Yeah, but again, Coastless, they didn't get a single kill. On that anti-eco round, you can actually see there's only one death on the board. They've only gotten one kill, and that came in the pistol round off of the back of Invert, who's having latency issues right now. But they don't do any of the economical damage that they needed to do in that last round. They don't force any of the rebuys. They don't get the bomb plant, so it's going to be another full save for them. And already up on four rifles and an AWP for Peter. So this is looking pretty good for FollowEsports early on in this matchup.
And of course, for Coastless now, off of the hinges of that force up, won't really be able to go for too much this time. Probably just going to see P250s at the most. And this will be an easy third pickup now, but as I believe you've already mentioned, with nobody going down there in that first round, it's going to let them stack up a whole lot of cash, and probably even more so. With how clean that last one went, we could obviously expect sort of the same result coming into the full eco from Coastless. And Follow Esports will actually have a whole lot of excess money going into the first gun round. We can already see Peter, too, has gone for this op upgrade very, very early on. So assuming he doesn't end up going down, or just assuming that that op isn't lost at all, that's saving a lot of money that might have potentially needed to have been bought out there in the fourth round.
Yeah, that's a big early investment for Follow Esports. Obviously, Peter favors the AWP. The other side of that is kind of, you know, if he gets dropped, like you were saying, if he gets dropped here, that's... You know, he's invested $5,000 into this one, so that's a very big investment coming out from him. So this is a high-risk, high-reward position for Peter to be in. He's got a... I expect a little bit more of a passive setup, maybe go... He's got a mid-spawn, so he might go for an early pick in mid. They're not going to have firepower to just drop him or trade him instantaneously in middle, so he should be able to get a little bit of a free shot off in mid on any of those players that are pushing out through the T-stairs. But... then he'll probably fall back to the arch side and play a little bit more of a passive angle. I expect. Who knows?
So we're just waiting for the unpause now at this point. Unfortunately, not a whole lot that we can add on at this point. But thankfully, just as we run out of things to talk about, the pause is going to unpause itself right there. So we'll go right back into this match. And it's going to be, once more, as we expected, pretty much the full eco here from Coastless. They're not buying up anything at all. They're actually just going to take this match super raw, only using their Glocks. No armor, no utility, nothing. And we expect this one to be over very, very quickly indeed.
There you go. Peter gets the first one, looking for another shot. He's actually going to go on the truck side. Spots a second one, looking for more. That smoke comes in, all-encompassing in that mid-corridor. So they're not going to press on forward here on the terrace side, but he's going to switch his angle, and this is smart. He's got lemz over there in boiler. Going to get the three-piece, and he's looking for a couple more here. Invert and ScrunK falling back, but Stewie's already in mid, so ScrunK's not really going to have an avenue of falling back here, and a little bit of damage being done there as Stewie cleans up ScrunK. Invert should fall immediately afterwards. He's only on a pistol. And there you go. aKis cleans him up. 3-0. Flawless execution of these anti-ecos. Only one kill on the board so far for the Coastless squad. And coming into the first gun round, if you look at the scoreboard, 5-4-3-2-1. Make a wish.
Whoa! Crazy. I've sent it the same thing on the T side, but Coastless again. Now they'll go for their full buy here. Oh, what the? A little bit of a misclick there from FGB as draWsouL is gonna
rip.
Take a little bit of a love tap there on the butt at the beginning of the round. Just some team, love coming out there. But as he presses forward, aKis will pick up the first kill from the CTs, finding another one. It's right back to that pistol round play once again. Invert tries to hold, but he's gonna get killed by rooRoo there. Lemz and FGB picking up two kills directly after that. FGB still holding back over by logs, but overpeaks that just a little bit. So aKis is gonna shut him down, and just like that, we're into a one-on-one where it's aKis versus lemz. Lemz already packing a little bit of heat on himself. They're down to 46 HP, but nonetheless pressing forward confidently, but a little bit too much as aKis is gonna find the easy frag. He escapes down with a 3K, and FB win the first gun round.
Not as clean, but look at how much economy they have on the CT side. That's huge. Now, Peter's going to get dropped and up. aKis is going to be able to buy up. And this is a pretty big investment again from the CT side, but you can see Stewie's on that farm mode right now. He's got that MP9. Expect a little bit of aggression to come from him. It looks like it's going to be a... Well, they're going to turtle up a little bit here on the terrace side. That early aggression from Follow Esports, two out of the four rounds, is really gonna play mind games with Coastless now. They're gonna have to play extremely passive, extremely slow, and wait for that pressure to come. And by the time that they realize that, hey, this round it's not actually coming, they're gonna have to really move to get in these bomb sites, because then map control is gonna be all over for Follow Esports.
And rooRoo, along with Stewie, playing it very forward back over here by the car angle, waiting to see if Coastless are gonna press out from there. They're trying to get this boost going, but in the meantime, that apartment's push not going very well at all, and rooRoo just lining them up over here. Stewie, he wants a little bit of action, can't find it, and knife part two, he's gonna grab it. Shuts down Invert.
What is happening right now?
And FE, still with no deaths coming into this round. Obviously the gun round a little bit different, but that's another round now where they keep five alive, so those that they did lose money out of the last round, they've just reestablished it. And their money's right back into a really good spot.
Yeah, that's the big thing, actually. Stewie's staying on this MP9, so he's just going to play a cheeky angle and try to pop some domes as they come around the corner. But another full buy here for Coastless, but they have looked absolutely awful on their anti-eco routes.
It's obviously a very unorganized Coast here, just trying to make something work. And I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. This is definitely looking like it's... Oh, hold on. We'll talk more about this in a second. And Stewie's going to get a little over-aggressive. FGB catches the hamstring there and shuts him down. Nice little headshot. Takes out Stewie. And they do have a little bit of an avenue opened up. It's going to cause rotation over from the A site, too. So they're going to move Roo back over here on the highway to be in a floater position. But Peter seems to be handling himself quite well. Picks up one shot in FGB. And that's going to hold back a little bit more of the aggression for the time being over there on the side of Coastless.
Nice bait there. Peter does go down to Invert, but rooRoo was there for the backup, takes down ScrunK, so we're still on a 3v3 even strength. Invert with the bomb on his back over there by himself, so this is a little bit scary. You can actually see aKis pushing up into the boiler room. lemz actually gets himself down, so they do have mid control, but they haven't cleared out aKis over here by boiler, and they're going to go to battle. There it is. lemz and draWsouL are actually going to find that, but the rotation is already on. You can see Slemmy is over here just popping some shots to hold him back. rooRoo on a long rotation, still trying to make his way over. That bomb is going to get planted default, and now two players playing, one in graveyard, one in pit, and one on truck side. So, Slemmy and rooRoo, they've got a lot of work ahead of them still.
Invert will pop right out, picks up one shot, now bringing everything down onto Slemmy's hands at this point, and this is probably going to prompt the save as he exits out to the mid-choke point. We'll look for any sort of extra aggression that he can maybe find on these players, but with no utility, already some reduced health, and obviously still three players alive from Coast, this wouldn't be too smart to press forward to that. His money situation for the rest of the team, not in the worst spot. They will definitely still be able to go for a full rebuy heading into the next round, but saving that M4 isn't going to hurt.
And actually, I'm surprised that it didn't run over to B, because that's where Peter's AWP was down. Might have been able to pick that up and save it, but Coastless now on the board, 5-1. Now is there's going to be a little bit of trepidation on their side. They still have a decent bank built up after that losing bonus. They're going to buy down on two of their players. If they lose this round, they should still be able to formulate a buy behind it, but losing two in a row would reset their money completely, and then FollowEsports would be on a sensational half at that point.
So, looking now with Coastless getting themselves onto the board, now going to be given a chance to press it forward now, and that was a very much so needed round. I wanted to say before that some of the big problems that we were seeing here was the fact that, obviously, they were looking very unorganized, and that seemed to carry over from the end of that last map there, too. It was almost sort of, like I said, I really hate to use this word in cast, but it almost looked like the team was sort of on tilt there towards the end, and it sort of carried over to the beginning of this map, as everything just didn't really look like it was going anywhere. Very uncoordinated, just, let's do this, I guess, and it was sort of, wasn't a whole lot of confidence from Coastless, but now that they pick up that one round, maybe this can help them to sort of reestablish things, and this is starting to look a little bit more organized now in this round.
Yeah, pretty standard setup here. They actually go a little heavy on the banana presence early on from the Coastless side, but they're going to fall back, pick up the bomb, and work up towards the A bomb site. And rooRoo's cheating over here towards A, so this is a little bit scary for Coastless if they do execute towards mid, as there are going to be four CTs in their face, and rooRoo's actually going to take the full commitment over here towards arch side. Peter, just playing from library, looking for anything. They pick up the bomb and work back towards down B. And this could be the right call from Coastless. But now Peter's going to hightail it over. rooRoo cleaning out the alternate mid. They're going to be able to find any kind of... cleaning out brackets, pardon me. aKis getting aggressive. lemz still in boiler. He's going to pick out and actually gets that kill. But no rotation back from the CTs. Peter's going to find first blood. Still looking for another one. And actually blind ScrunK trying to work his way in. Stewie2k just pulls. He's going to be able to find that kill. And things just crumbling over here at this B bomb site. They're going to push on through these smokes, but it's going to be Stewie again. Finding a second one, looking for a third. Peter in the smoke. Fully flashed. He's going to pull out the pistol. And he's going to have to combine kill, but it's Stewie coming up absolutely massive at B with the 4K.
Big Stew. Holding there
absolutely
strong.
Absolutely massive.
So plays himself forward and really aggressive there too, even using the opponent's smokes as sort of his advantage here to just catch some of these positions. Here's the footsteps rolling in, just times the shots perfectly to execute some of those players. So a big play from him to hold things off. Coastless again, sort of lackadaisically just trying to throw themselves at the B side in hopes that they'll maybe kill Stewie and clear things out from that point forward. But like I said before, it looked organized there at the beginning, but when the actual site take started on B, just really didn't seem like it was very much so on for those guys, as the calls weren't really happening and whatnot, and obviously Stewie was just left to his own devices to do whatever he needed to clean things up.
Yeah, and he did it well. I mean, there's no questions asked on that one. You can actually see this is a little bit of a mishmash as far as the buy is concerned here for Coastless. They've got three AKs, and then the two pistols that they have actually don't have any armor behind them. And Peter, he's actually going to drop one of the rifles early on in this round with a nice peek in mid. AKs onto FGB, and things just not looking good for Coastless on this map. Peter again, draWsouL down, and the aggression in apartments is actually nice coming from aKis right now, so he's going to be looking for another one here in alternate mid or maybe behind him in apartments, but he's going to take the peek out. He doesn't realize that invert is directly below him, but should be able to read this. Ooh, yeah, lemz coming from behind is going to clean him up.
So Lem's gonna take him down. Slemmy finding the trade from long haul back over there, and then Rue's gonna clean things up, and this is a very much so needed tactical pause coming out from Coastless at this point, as they're finally gonna realize it. Yeah, guys, things are not really going well here at all, and they're gonna have to take a moment to sort of recenter themselves, and hopefully readjust their attitudes here too, because like I said before, this is beyond just some normal issues they'd see from teams. It just seems very off at the moment from Coastless. Unfortunately, not a very good way to describe things, but you can definitely tell.
Oh yeah, I mean they're on the struggle bus right now, and it's not doing too well for them. Obviously, Peter's having a little bit of a match here, 9-2, Slimmy 6-1. I mean everybody's performing here on the CT side. Everybody's contributing. You see, 9 kills for the top player, 6 kills for the bottom player. So three frags separating top and bottom. Whereas on the other side, ScrunK yet to get on the board. He's 0-0-8. DraWsouL is 1-1-7. Lemz, top fragging for them at 5-7. So really tough position for Coastless to be in. They need to get something working. They need to start finding those kills, and they're not really going to be in a position to do that because their eco rounds, have been so lackluster in the get frags department. So, you know, we're looking at an 8-1 scoreline, and FollowEsports on these eco rounds have been flawless. They haven't lost a single player on any of these eco rounds. So if they can continue to execute, you can just see that money stacking up. Stewie2k has got almost $11,000 after the buy down.
You bring up Peter too, and like he's been just one of the players that, to be honest, he's got a great frag total, but it's because he's sort of been being fed kills for almost every single round there. They're just walking right into him, no utility or anything being used. So that's one example of things just being off right now, but this is looking good. Working their way through mid choke point there. Ake is wide out in the open. They're able to pick up that kill. Now they round themselves around. Slemmy doesn't realize the bush is coming in, but thankfully he's going to roll his way out. Gets two in a row. FGB and Invert both falling down, and now that's completely going to kill the push here from Coastless for the most part.
Yeah, Peter playing very aggressively over here on chalk side actually pays with his life, so it's going to be a 3-on-2. So this eco round looking a lot better than the last couple ones, but they dropped the bomb over there by the moto pit, and they're, well, everything is just completely smoked off now. So not really an avenue of attack here for the terrorist side. As you can see, Lemz does have that salvaged AWP. He's looking for a frag, but Ruru's going to spot him out over top of that smoke. And Slimmy's going to execute the 4K. So a huge hold over there on the moto side from Slemmy. The Molotov followed up by the spray down. And that just completely thwarts that push from the Coastless side.
And again, not a bad amount of damage being done here. We can see with the revives coming out, Peter's going to have to actually completely empty out his bank account here. But obviously some more tilting going on there too. When you look at the rest of the team, it's sort of just in descending order here when you look at most of the roster there, at least from the left side. Stewie's hitting at 13.3k, you got 9k still in Slemmy. The rest beyond that, they were actually kind of low. So they're doing a good job of putting a dent in the economy. It's just obviously with these CTs leading by such a big round score, it's the fact that they need to start picking up rounds, which is really killing them. And although they bring it close a couple times, just not enough to come out on top near the end of it. And it's the same thing that we saw back on the last map as well, where those teams were trading rounds back and forth.
Yeah, Peter didn't need to go for that buy. Stewie could have definitely dropped him because Stewie's going to max out in money after this round is over. He'll be up near 16k. And if nobody dies from the CT side, then that's just wasted money. You know, you talk about the economy game and how intelligent you have to be with the money. And obviously, Stewie, sitting at 13-3 right now, he needs to be buying his teammates if they die. He needs to be dropping them rifles and things like that to prevent any of this extra stuff. And actually, now he's going to have to rebuy this next round. So that's actually not awful.
Well, if the rest of his teammates die, if the rest of his teammates die, he's more than likely going to have to drop for them anyway if they want a full buy. So kind of would have been forced into it in the next round. I imagine that's why he didn't do it here, just in case this happened on the gun round. So that might explain it. But you're definitely still right in that, you know, such a drastic difference between 13k and 0 should still not be happening. You should try to keep your teammates as even as possible. So with the rest of Coastless now, they're going to push their way back over here towards the A site. Peter putting himself in pit, but wide open here if aKis doesn't come out on top with his shots here too, especially if they just drop right down. But they're going to push in. Slemmy finding the first kill here, and aKis catching that push, but it's a little slow. Less able to adjust his aim and line it up for more here too. Catches FGB through the smoke. Slemmy wrapping around, he's going to pick up another kill, and Invert does trade that, but beyond this, Invert going to be heavily pressured from all directions essentially at this point. Just have to find him out. He's using the smoke pretty well, but on the open, he finds one kill, dropping down, taking the heat, and nowhere near enough time to adjust that aim. So aKis is going to be able to finish things off. He comes out of this round with a 3k, and FollowEsports will pick up a 9th point here.
That double pit play is just so strong on Inferno. You've heard Moses talk about it in the past. You know, obviously they lost a member early over at the B-bomb site with Stewie2k going down. The terrorists decide to push on towards that A-bomb site, and they're playing very passively with Slemmy cheating towards that B-bomb site just in case the pressure comes that direction. And Slemmy actually does get that nice kill on that player wrapping around towards the moto side, and that just leaves Peter and aKis to clean up on that pit side. So good defense there from Follow Esports. They're able to lock it down, and now Peter's going to be going for another aggressive peek here in mid. They are just going to push aKis up through halls, just throwing out some flashbangs and some smokes. And yeah, now it's just, what does Coastless do? They're down 9-1. They need to put rounds on the board if they want to play CT side, and just not looking good for him at all.
And Peter, again, after not finding anything initially, just in case there's an alt-mid rush in his direction, does decide to press himself over to the safe cubby corner. rooRoo is actually going to be challenged pretty early on. Wide peek, but he finds a kill anyway, but gets traded. There's Stewie, though. Not expected to be over there by Spold. He picks up one more, puts it back into an even tray, but as he wide peeks too, inVert going to catch another kill. Now they should know it's rolling in, but aKis is smart to hold back there in the porch. Picks up the easy kill on the flanker, and now it's just a 3-on-1 once again, which we should be able to see the CTC that close out, and then Bibu shout with Slemmy catching that rotation there, that attempt to flank from inVert.
Smart play from Peter. It looked like he wanted to push through that smoke at first. Decides that once aKis got that kill over in mid, that there wasn't going to be two players, so he didn't have to try to take a fight. And falls back intelligently behind that smoke and waits for his teammate to rotate in. Slemmy actually saving his life at the end by getting that kill. So, you know, they do lose a couple of players, but again, you talked about that money game, and they're still perfectly fine for the remainder of this half, pretty much on the CT side.
So now, for the rest of Coastless once again, all sort of trapped by the crossroads. Smoke comes out, so they don't really want to press their way through over here, over up Banana, but they just decide to go for it anyway with this pop flash coming through. CTs realize this, and they get another smoke going in, but there's going to be Peter, finds a leg, but they're both completely flashed. They have to fall back here. That gives a little bit of room. This rush is going to come in quick. It's going to be a high-pressure situation. Stewie's able to manage it anyway. FGB and inVert both already going down. He finds a third here over onto lemz, and going to try to find the fourth. Over peek a little bit, but still able to keep himself alive. And now Peter comes out to party too. StarSeries going to be able to drop him, looking for the second, almost finds it, but rooRoo at the end of the day does take him down.
Yeah, and again, just another lackluster push into the B-bomb site. Granted, it was a save round there for the terrorist side, but they get two drops. They can't really do anything behind that. Now it's Slemmy is the high bank. You saw Stewie a couple rounds ago. He's bought down to 6,300, but this time it's going to be Slemmy on 13K. So they're fine for money for the rest of this half. Talking about Follow Esports, 11-1 is the scoreline. Nothing that that Coastless can do. Just a really rough go at this one.
Peter catching another leg shot there on FGB. They know that presence is back in middle, so they'll be a little bit more cautious, but already FGB down to 16 HP here at the beginning. The rest of Coastless trying to work their way back up over here through all mid and middle, but not expecting this push on Banana. Stewie's going to find a kill. Slemmy also caught one as well, so this push from Coastless is going to be squandered before it even begins, and whoa! We see FGB looking all sorts of places as he goes to the mid checkpoint. He's going to pick up a kill, but as Stewie presses through, going to catch lemz down with the op. Lemz, unfortunately, looking in the complete wrong direction to counter this, and just like that, we're over here on a draWsouL now. As the final player left alive in a 1-on-4, this Molly comes in. Probably going to be able to find aKis here, but now, can he get anything more? And he has a back shot to work with here. Rooroo's not going to connect it at first, but he's going to be able to wrap around the corner and finish things off.
Yeah, and Follow Esports, this is just a dominant performance on Inferno. They got the knife round, they got the start on CT side, and they're just on cruise control right now. There's nothing that Coastless can do. Just looking at the scoreboard right now, there have only been two plants the entirety of this first half, and one of them was the round that Coastless actually won in the sixth. That's the only round that they got on the board. They've only gotten into the bomb site twice. So that's just a testament to how Follow Esports are playing on this defensive side. I mean, it's just cleaning house, and you can just see from the scoreboard that, with the exception of one round where three of the players stayed alive on Coastless, everybody's died every round.
So Coastless again here. Just trying to play over
and look
here.
At rooRoo.
Yep, rooRoo on the flank. I was just about to mention this. Nobody watching it. Again, same problem that happened last map. Nobody watching flanks. They're going to press through. They're just focused completely on this. And there's aKis finding a 2-for-1 just on lemz. Peter rounds the corner and finishes it off. This has been a problem that we've seen from Coastless, not just here, but on the last map too, that was constantly surfacing up for them. They would take control of sites, but then they would leave so many angles open, like specifically on A site, back over on Mirage. Ticket box was left open so many times, and like nobody calls if they're leaving this open or something, so they just press in through ticket box or whatever. In this case, of course, they press in through Banana. The call doesn't come out, and it's like, oh, whoa, we're losing these players. Now we have to suddenly react to this, and it just doesn't work out for Coastless, no matter how much they try to just try to play it by ear, essentially.
Yeah, now the aggression coming up towards B, but it's a triple op setup on the CT side. Well, he got the money. Why not go for it? So the early aggression is going to be quelled there. Stewie's going to find one, but they answer back. Invert's going to find that frag on the Stewie. aKis goes down to draWsouL, so a little bit of a chance here to put at least another... Well, never mind. He's going to say another round on the board, but that's Peter and Slemmy chiming in with another couple of frags. It's Invert and ScrunK left alive, and already this mid-aggression. Once again, ScrunK from pit. He's going to be able to find one as Invert takes down rooRoo. So we are in a 1v1, Slemmy versus ScrunK, but that bomb is down on a ramp. And now ScrunK has got to make something happen here.
So now we'll see exactly what ScrunK can do. Thankfully, he's got plenty of time to work with here, so he can definitely play some mind games with Slemmy. Slemmy, of course, it's basically a 50-50 risk on the site take, so he's going to shift himself over towards B. I believe this is going to be the wrong choice, but also while all this is happening, he can, if he just wants to get super aggressive, which is what it looks like he's doing, he can just push down Banana and try to sort of flank the flank, as it were. But doesn't look like he's going to press himself any further here. For the time being, then over by the wheelbarrow. But as time presses further and further, ScrunK has to play it very cautiously too, because it's sort of the
he's
same thing
know
for
now.
Him.
ScrunK just threw the smoke out, so Slemmy knows that there's nothing over here in Banana, so he's just going to hightail it over towards A. That's a bad call from ScrunK. He threw that out, and now Slemmy is going to be on a fast flank coming up mid, and ScrunK, with not a lot of time to play with, has got to get into the site, and now Slemmy is just perched and ready to peek out on him, so this is very risky, and now ScrunK just peeks right into it. That was that smoke. I get what he was trying to do. He was trying to pull a distraction and make sure that Slimmy's over at the B bomb site, but that smoke actually completely backfires because Slemmy was already pushed out by trucks, by car outside of B. So he knows, hey, this smoke actually got thrown from A. So good attempt from ScrunK, but it actually backfires in the long run.
So that's basically going to be it here. I mean, I'm going to be completely honest with you, I don't think Coastless have a chance to come back. 14 rounds, if FollowEsports win the pistol, we're definitely over with.
But oh, no. This is done.
Yeah, if Coastless win the pistol, then there's a very, very, very small chance. I'll be honest, if they do come back, not gonna say that'll do anything, but if they do come back, that'll be very surprising. But the odds are so, so low at this point that more than likely FollowEsports should just be able to close this out and finish off with a 2-0.
Big thing right here, though, is that the new Follow Esports squad, they're trying to get their way up into the Pro League division, playing in Premier this season. Coastless is a Pro League team, and Coastless has not been performing all that fantastic in Pro League, so this might actually end up being one of those relegation matches you see at the end of the season, depending on where Follow Esports finishes up in the Premier division.
So now, as we see again here, what'll be happening on this pistol? Coastless already taking a little bit of heat here. Same story for FE, but ScrunK and Drossel already down to 72 and 63. Big four-man push coming up Banana right now, and they've already started to rotate assets back over towards A, but thankfully inVert and FGB, they call off the flanker, and they pick up a kill off into this initial push. ScrunK finding one as well over here onto aKis, picking up a second on rooRoo. Now it's all on Slemmy in a one-on-five. Very low chance indeed of him clutching this one out, but he's going to try, but it won't pan out. All five alive for Coastless, and they pick up the pistol.
Yeah, so a little bit of life being breathed into Coastless, but long road ahead of them.
Indeed, 12 rounds to do. Just to tie the scoreline, and well, 14, the entire amount of Follow Esports' rounds total score at this point needed to actually win this match and surprise pretty much everybody in this chat room at this point to take us to map 3, because that would be a huge comeback. 1-14 comeback. Can you imagine? I probably just jinxed it and now it's going to happen, but can you imagine?
No, I can't. I don't think that that's possible. I don't think Coastless is going to come back from this.
All right, so again, the players of Follow Esports go for a quick attempt back over here to the outside. Drossel slows it down, but we can see the trades coming back out there. inVert, thankfully, going to put it back under the control of the CTs now. And as Slemmy and Stewie, they press their way back in. They do have full control back over here of the sort of the apartments, along with the porch wrap side. Moose is looking to get some of their players back in a position to move towards that, but you have to remember here, most of these FE players, they haven't taken any damages yet, but neither do they have any armor, and this is going to make cleaning them up fairly simple. ScrunK picks up one of these kills. FGB is going crazy with the P90 there, checking every single spot he can. He's going to pick up the final one, and that will be the third point, of course, as we expect coming onto the board now for Coastless.
But you saw in the first half how flawless Follow Esports were on their anti-eco rounds. With that bomb plant for Follow Esports, they probably should be able to buy, because I don't think they put any kind of an investment into that last round. You can see them all hovering around $4,000. Yeah, they're going to play it safe. Why not? They've got plenty of rounds to work with, so they're just going to play it safe.
Yeah, I mean, there's no reason to really force anything out of it. I mean, if they just wanted to get it over with, they could do that, but obviously playing the safe game is not going to hurt them at all either here. Just in case there is a big surprise, and Coastless are like 90 billion times better on their CT side than their T side is.
Yeah, but, you know, again, 14-3, 11 rounds the difference. It's going to be a couple of armor pistols going on for the Follow Esports side, but the rest of them are just going to be on slightly upgraded pistols. They're going to be pushing their way up mid again. They had success over here the last time. Invert's on an AWP, but they're going to push on over towards Limbs' side, and they actually get one out in front, and Invert drops. That's an off for Peter if he gets it. There is one more to beat in pit, but nice positioning there from rooRoo. Actually yields himself another gun. And he's going to go to battle with ScrunK. ScrunK is going to be able to pre-fire and win, but we're down to a 2v2 post-plant. And this time, the HP advantage going the way of the terrorist side. Stewie is going to be playing here in sight, just looking for that Juan Deeg. He spotted the shoulder of ScrunK. Not able to find it just yet. Nays around the corner, but it's going to be Peter here in the site with his AWP. This is Follow Esports trying to lose now, and Stewie nails the headshot with the deagle, and now we're on match point. And Follow Esports, there it is. That's something that Coastless couldn't do. They couldn't get in and get the bomb plants. They couldn't get the post plant positions, and Follow Esports does it on an eco round. So really, really tough spot for Coastless, and they just there's no chance of recovery at this point.
And all of the money that was expunged in the previous two rounds, of course, when you look at Coastless, they're not really going to have all that much coming into this one. Upgrade pistols with armor on a couple players and two M4s, but no utility at all. And if they had it, it's already been used here. So we will see a one-for-one trade to begin things, but they're trying to take a page out of Follow Esports SCT sidebook. Not really working out so well. Already down to just the two B-site defenders here. One's trying to rotate. FGB holds his own back over there and picks up one kill, but Peter's there for the trade. And now the push is actually going to come back over towards the B-site, but it's not even going to be needed. Follow Esports clean things up. And that's going to close out our second map and the set here with a final score of 16-3 on map number 2 and a set score of 2-0 in the favor of the new Follow Esports.
Just really sloppy on that Coastless side. Just really, really sloppy. Terra side, they couldn't get any traction. Their Mirage looked good. 16-13 was the scoreline for the finale of Mirage. Able to close that one out was Follow Esports. But Team Coast, they didn't look bad on Mirage, but their map pick was Inferno. And they got 16-3.
That really begs the question as to, like, why
so, did we pick this? Yeah, so that was, a little bit of a risky play there. But nevertheless, Follow Esports come out on top. Kudos to them as they move on. So good job from them.
And that is going to close out the stream for tonight, guys. And as well, I believe that's the only streams that we have going, at least in the North American sector for this week. Things should be resuming next week, starting on Monday. We'll have more details on to who exactly is going to be streaming that when we get closer to that. But once again, thank you all very much for tuning in. We will see you next time, and hopefully we'll get a chance to catch you for some of the European group stages, which will be continuing next week as well. But my name is Blue. Joining me this evening was Mega Man. If you'd like to follow either of us on Twitter, it's in the title. And in case you can't see that, I'm at BLUCSGO, and Mega Man, pretty simple, at Mega Man TV. Thank you guys once again for tuning in, and we'll see you next time here at StarLadder.